Philippines reports its highest single-day rise in COVID-19 cases on Thursday, July 30, with 3,954 new cases, bringing the total number of confirmed cases to 89,374. The country also reported a record high number of new recoveries, 38,089, leading to a steep rise of total recoveries to 65,078. For this reason, the country's active cases shrink to 22,327. The day before, the active cases were at 56,528. Meanwhile, the death toll rises to 1,983. The Department of Health says the sharp increase in both confirmed cases and recoveries is due to enhanced data reconciliation efforts between the national and local governments. For recoveries, the DOH retagged as recovered those mild and asymptomatic cases who do not deteriorate 14 days after their symptoms began or their swab samples were collected. The DOH says reconciliation of data on recoveries will be reported every 15 days. Meanwhile, the national government cancels its plan to require all locally stranded individuals or LSIs to undergo a swab test before arriving in their home provinces. Instead, the burden on testing is placed on the individual's hometowns or local governments. Presidential spokesman Harry Roque also says LSIs just need to take a rapid antibody test. Rapid tests are not as accurate as swab tests, which remain the gold standard of COVID-19 testing. In related news, businessman Jaime Augusto Zubeldi Ayala argues targeted lockdown and data-driven decisions instead of freezing Metro Manila again will curb COVID-19 infections. Tycoon Manny Pangilinan also backs mass testing for targeted sectors given the country's limited healthcare resources. Days after President Rodrigo Duterte's State of the Nation address, China vows to prioritize the Philippines' request for a coronavirus vaccine. In his address last Monday, July 27, Duterte said he pleaded with Chinese President Xi Jinping to prioritize the Philippines. In a briefing, Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesperson Wang Wenbin says, quote, "The Philippines is a friendly close neighbor and we will give priority to its needs once we succeed in developing a vaccine." But Vice President Leni Robredo says the Philippines will not be able to stop the crippling coronavirus pandemic if Duterte's government will just wait for a vaccine.
Hindi mapipigil ang pandemya kung basta mag-aabang na lang tayo sa bakuna. Kailangan maampat ang pagkalat nito sa lalong madaling panahon.
Foreign Secretary Teddy Boy Loxin says the Philippine government will summon the Malaysian ambassador to the country after their foreign minister criticized his statement on the Sabah issue. This comes a day after Malaysian Foreign Minister Hishamuddin Hussein calls his remarks on the Sabah issue as irresponsible and damaging to bilateral relations with Malaysia. In an onslaught of tweets, Loxin draws parallels between the Philippines' territorial claims in the West Philippine Sea and Sabah as he asserts each country is entitled to make its claim of ownership. The unfolding issue between the Philippines and Malaysia brings Sabah back into the limelight. Sabah is a territory claimed by the Philippines but occupied by Malaysia. Hussein on Wednesday night says Malaysia would summon Philippine Ambassador Charles Jose over Loxin's earlier tweet that, quote, "Sabah is not in Malaysia if you want to have anything to do with the Philippines." Four Hong Kong pro-independence activists are arrested by police on Wednesday, July 29, under a controversial new national security law. The arrests are the first to target public political figures since the sweeping legislation was imposed by Beijing late June. Police say student activists aged between 16 and 21 are arrested on suspicion of organizing and inciting secession. The group Student Localism releases a statement saying its former leader, 19-year-old Tony Chung, was among those arrested. The security law has sent a chill through Hong Kong. The new law empowers China's security agents to operate openly in Hong Kong for the first time. At least 15 people have now been arrested under the new law since it was enacted on June 30. The head of a U.S. Congressional Antitrust Committee warns tech giants Amazon, Apple, Google, and Facebook are too powerful and will likely emerge from the coronavirus pandemic even stronger. Tim Cook of Apple, Jeff Bezos of Amazon, Mark Zuckerberg of Facebook, and Sundar Pichai of Alphabet, the parent company of Google, appear jointly by video before the House of Representatives subcommittee conducting an investigation into market dominance. Democratic lawmakers question the vast market power of the companies, while Republicans accuse Facebook and Google in particular of stifling conservative voices. Rhode Island Representative David Cicilline calls them the emperors of online economy, whose powers must not go unchecked and to which users must not bow.
Simply put, they have too much power. This power staves off new forms of competition, creativity, and innovation. The dominant platforms have wielded their power in destructive, harmful ways in order to expand.
Cicilline adds, big tech companies' power and size are incompatible with democracy. He says one symptom of the situation is that users aren't able to find a real alternative to these platforms despite privacy and security issues. Ohio Representative Jim Jordan slams Google for censoring right-wing website Breitbart and Facebook for suppressing conservative views.
I'll just cut to the chase. Big tech's out to get conservatives. That's not a suspicion, that's not a hunch, that's a fact.
But Facebook Zuckerberg and Google's Pichai push back.
Our goal is to offer a platform for all ideas. We want to give everyone in the world a voice.
You know, we approach our work in a nonpartisan way. We'll continue to conduct ourselves in a neutral way.
A post circulating in messaging apps claims the Philippine Food and Drug Administration approved a traditional Chinese medicine for treating COVID-19 patients. This is false. The message going around apps such as Viber says FDA finally approved this Chinese medicine for COVID patients. Wasted 5 months, but still, late is better than never. The message also has an attached screenshot of a Facebook post with boxes of the traditional Chinese medicine called Lianhua Qingwen Qiao Nang. The FDA has not approved the concoction for treating COVID-19. On the contrary, it warned the public on May 6 against purchasing and using the product. A report published on May 23 says authorities raided a warehouse in Bacoor City where thousands of capsules were confiscated. The police arrested two Chinese for selling the product.